Well, thank everybody for coming out. And what we're going to do is start in prayer, like we should. And Mr. Wallace will do that for us.
Let us bow for prayer. God, we're grateful for this opportunity of gathering. We ask that you clear our minds, clear our hearts. Let everything we say be done decently and in order. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And next, what I'd like for everyone to do is to go around, introduce your business, who you are, how long you've been in business, and what maybe you hope to get out of this group. And I'll start. My name is Tricia Shank. I have Deja Vu Upscale Consignment. We have two locations. One is inside the mall in a recently opened business in Watson Chapel. I love Pine Bluff. I hope this group, we can change the stereotype of Pine Bluff and get people to educate it on doing business locally. They don't have to go to Little Rock for what they need. Everything they need is here. And every time they spend money in Little Rock, they're supporting their fire department, their police department. Let's spend the money on ours.
My name is Luke Matheson. I own Arkansas Varsity LLC. We're a company that is in with Yahoo Sports, and we cover high school and college sports in the state of Arkansas, primarily south of Little Rock. I've been in business 10 years. I am a Pine Bluff High School graduate. And matter of fact, you looked on my website today, you'll see a Pine Bluff High guy, John Tate, that's on there right now. And, you know, our primary goal and objective is we go out and we identify guys that are and ladies that are going to go play college ball somewhere, regardless if it's Division I, Division II, NAIA, or regardless of where they're going to play, and we try to help them get their names out there. We will cover the games kind of like a newspaper will. The difference between us and a newspaper, I'm real time. I don't have to wait till tomorrow to put a story up. I can put it up within 10 minutes of getting it. So, you know, people hear about us. There's people around the entire state know who we are. And she mentioned the perspective of how people think of Pine Bluff when they find out I'm from Pine Bluff. You get a few looks every now and then. But I've had offers to go other places. Trisha knows about a few of them, but I've always opted to stay here.
My name's Tony Anderson. I got Blake Street Muffler. I've been in business since March of 2008. Main reason I came is to, like y'all say, try to make a better image for where we live. I'm very proud of where I come from. Graduated from Dalloway High School. My kids still go here, you know, and make a better place for them and everyone else. I mean, I'm all up for doing whatever.
Good morning. I'm Debbie Hollingsworth, and I am your current mayor of Pine Bluff. But before that, I was a small business owner myself, and I've been in Pine Bluff for 41 years, raised my two daughters here, graduated from Pine Bluff High School. I think that small businesses are the backbone of any healthy community. I think that as a city, my opinion is that the citizens became very complacent with where they were and what was going on. Now we realize that complacency has gotten us to where we are today. And as a city, I believe that we have got to implement very strong, well thought out strategies as to how we can repurpose Pine Bluff, how we can create that new image for our city, and also to be able to say that, look, shopping locally, that's our tax base, and we have to do that. So how do we create that? And I applaud each and every one of you to come to the table today to become a think tank on how we are able to do that. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Reggie Cole. I'm born and raised in Pine Bluff, Arkansas, a proud graduate of Watson Chapel High School. I did two tours in the Marine Corps. Come back. I now own one health and wellness store called Natural Bliss, 7203 Sheridan Road, Suite K. Our goal is to open up another health store downtown Pine Bluff because I believe in Pine Bluff. And I remember how vibrant Pine Bluff was. And I still believe in the city. So that's why I'm here, and that's why I believe that we can do great things together.
Good morning. My name is Sean Davis. I'm the owner of VIP Detailing and Pressure Washing, located on 2801 Camden Road. Also, recently, the Percussion Room, Drum School, 4316 Dalloway Road. We've been open a year at VIP. enjoying the people of Pine Bluff. I've met pleasant people. Hopefully, and I believe we've done great work for people and constantly getting new ones. And the main thing I want people to understand or get out of this is that not only when you shop here are you getting spending money or anything, you're actually shopping with people who actually have passion for what they're doing. You're a part of the community, and we don't want you to just come spend money. We want you to feel good. We want you to get what you're actually paying for and more than that. So when they do come shop here and when they do spend that money, that they're dealing with people who are passionate about what they're doing.
Good morning. We're Troy and Christy Philbrook. We own the property shop and Southwind Property Services over off of Olive Street. We do property management, real estate. My Southwind Property Services does maintenance on rental properties and on some commercial things as well. We are not originally from Pine Bluff. We had moved up here. I worked originally with the Arsenal, but we've grown to love the area. We've moved into Pine Bluff. We feel called to be in Pine Bluff for business and other things. We believe there's wonderful people here. We've come to love the people that we've seen. There's a lot of good business owners that are doing their best with what they have here, and we see it growing. Same thing goes, you keep hearing about negative things. You see it changing, though. Over the last few years, you don't hear as much or see as much on when it's the first pull on the internet. So we are making progress in that, and we love to see that. We've seen that with one thing that's going to take is getting out and voting, you know. We're going to have to learn to vote the right people in the right place to do the right things for this time that we have nowadays. You know, it's time for us to move forward in that, but I'll get off the politics, sorry. I apologize for that. But we have a heart for it. We've moved we live in Pine Bluff now, right off of Olive Street, where our office is off of Olive Street, and we go to church on off of Ridgeway over there. So our entire life now is focused around Pine Bluff. We've loved the people, and all you got to do is go around meetings like this, see the diversity of everything. There is a way for this to work, and people like y'all are going to help make it happen. Thank you.
All right, my name is Timothy Wallace. I'm the owner. Excuse me, I have mom's holding on cold. Wow Wallace Flowers and Gifts, located on 1610 Brentwood Drive here in the city. Not unfortunately, we are on the foothills of opening our second store in Little Rock. We're about 3.5 months out. It's going to be a funeral-only store, Mr. Robinson. we've been open here in Pine Bluff about 2.5 years, maybe 2 years now. We love it. We're growing. We're very excited about that. And groups like this are going to make things much better. I'm a native of Pine Bluff, graduated from Pine Bluff High School, went to UAPB, graduated from there, then received my master's from Fayetteville, but came back home to teach at Pine Bluff High. Then I opened the floors. So we're looking forward to great things from organizations such as this.
Good morning. My name is Derek Urquhart. I own Country Chic Chocolate Company. I'm a native of Pine Bluff. I graduated from Watson Chapel High School in 2010. I started at UAPB. I haven't finished yet, but I am over halfway complete with my bachelor's in business management. I kind of took a break and I moved to Dallas. And when I moved to Dallas, I kind of started practicing and I guess working on a God-given talent. But anyway, I ended up moving back home to take care of my grandparents who were sickly. They have now passed away, but out of all of that, I did learn, you know, to craft my skills or to, you know, perfect my skills. And we started an organization called I Fight in Pink, which is a breast cancer survivor organization. And it's to promote awareness throughout the year rather than just in October, because my mom's a breast cancer survivor. So this all came about because we were looking for a fundraiser. And I made some chocolate-covered strawberries and put on Facebook. After I put them on Facebook, it kind of spread like wildfire. Like, people just started, where'd you get those? Or can you make me some? So it just kind of grew and grew, and it outgrew our house. So we were fortunate enough to find a building and to open up this chocolate store. And it's doing good. We've been open since November 6th, and we plan to open up a second location and to hopefully grow from there. But as of right now, our first location is doing good.
I need to find out more about that chocolate. My wife may not want me to bring it home, but I can just take it to my office.
Co-workers.
My name is Scott Robinson. I'm with Ralph Robinson's Son Funeral Home in Pine Bluff and a Pine Bluff High graduate. And, you know, for me, one of the things about what we do is I get to see wonderful people all the time. People talk about, you know, the positive and negative of Pine Bluff. And for me, even though I'm with a funeral home, I feel like I get to see wonderful people coming together to help each other all the time. And when I hear about people shopping in Little Rock, the two things I hear the most are that the stores in Pine Bluff don't have what they need, and the people, and they don't feel like they're treated right in stores. Those are bad perceptions that are no longer true. And so to me, what we need to do is do a better job of promoting ourselves, showing that, I mean, even for us, people won't come to us because we're in Pine Bluff. So, you know, to me, what we got to do is do a better job of, whether it's through videos or through other, you know, other ways, showing people that there are good folks, that you will be treated right if you do business here. We do have what you need. We just have to do a better job of promoting that. Now that, you know, our mayor and others have done a great job of bringing the crime down, to where that's not as big of an issue as it was. And then we also have to focus on education. We have to be able to develop people, because all everybody in business has issues finding good help. And so that's the other aspect we have to do. We have to focus on education. We have to be able to develop and keep good people, show that we are, that our businesses are good enough where people can come work with us, be treated right, be paid a fair wage, all that type of thing. And if we can do those things, we can get the education right, and we show people that they can shop here and get what they want, then we can get to that next level.
Hello, I'm Donald Hatchett. I am a candidate for 3rd Ward Alderman, Pine Bluff. I am here today because I will always be interested in hearing from businesses that are engaged in creating a positive image of Pine Bluff, creating a atmosphere where we can have tax-based growth that support things like lighting for our businesses and supporting policies, as I note in my platform, that encourage web-based payments of permitting services, web-based payments of services delivered by the city to businesses. Pine Bluff is a community that has many, many, many positives, including being a regional hub for business, services, healthcare services, and government services. I will continue to support businesses as I have in the past through my leadership roles with many of the organizations in this community that help people. I encourage the citizens of Pine Bluff to support change by endorsing organizations like initiatives like Go Forward, the 2020 initiative, and other initiatives from businesses that support Pine Bluff business. Thank you.
I am Marina Ross, and some of you already know me here. I'm from EMRO Videos. And so every time we Google Pine Bluff, what do we see? Mostly killing and drugs, unfortunately, right? So we have a very negative stereotype about Pine Bluff. So I'm here now, and my mission is to change that. I've been working closely with Pine Bluff Police Department, and we've created amazing, positive videos about Pine Bluff. So my goal, this is one of the reasons why I'm recording today. When we Google Pine Bluff, I wanted to see your business. I wanted to see positive videos finally, because it's all about the news. And we know even in national news, it's all about negative, okay? Now, I believe that video can change your business, and of course it can change the perspective and stereotype about Pine Bluff. Okay, and if you get, let's say, 100 customers or clients or voters a month, whatever you get, with video, it can change it to thousands. I highly believe that. I cannot even tell you how many clients I got because I watch my videos, but duh, I'm a videographer, but still, I sell the video product, okay? And people see my video, hey, they love it, they call me, okay? When they see your video, they see your business, your service, you know, your ideas, whatever you're selling, and guess what? They're going to call you, okay? Because our mind is programmed to motion picture. Yes, we're so used to pictures, but the actual motion, the image of motion, can help you grow your business. And the ultimate goal for me, okay, the way it works, and you know how Google works, when we put on that title the name of your business or service, whatever you're serving, and then in the end, Pine Bluff, Arkansas, Okay, when people Google Pine Bluff, Arkansas, what will pop up? Of course, your business, okay? And I want the world to know that we have great businesses in Pine Bluff and Whitehall. We have great people here, and it's just we need to change that through making more videos or pictures or a blog or whatever. Change that, you know, real people need to change it, not the news, okay? Because when we watch the news, what do we see? Oh, Pine Bluff is so bad. It's not the case. The only time, the only reason you will know that it's not the case if you live here, if you get to know people. And I've been here for a year. I know you can hear an accent. I'm originally from Ukraine, but I've been in America for 7 years. In Pine Bluff, I've been for a year, and I've been impressed how nice businesses are here, how caring people are here. So, if you guys want to make a video, I would really recommend that. And I'm from EMRO Videos. I will pass out cards later if you don't mind. So help me help you, and let's change the image of Pine Bluff to positive. Thank you. All
right. My name is Shannon Carruthers. I'm the owner of Shannon's restaurant about 5.5 years now. It's doing really good. So we have something going on, Pine Bluff. I'm a graduate of Dalloway High School. Love the 4th Ward. Love my city. And I try to fight for my city. And Scott was right when he said the help. I feel like your help, your employees, can make or break you. And what we desperately need in Pine Bluff is probably some classes on work ethics. For our help, even if it's once a month, one day a month, I think it would help. But anyway, I'm looking forward for growth, a lot of it.
All right, well, next we'll transfer this to our mayor. You have a challenge for us, is that what I understand? Okay.
Several months ago, I had the opportunity, I meet monthly with the Chamber and the Alliance, and we're the monthly meetings share what's going on with the chamber and also with parts of the Alliance. One of the things I proposed several months ago, and I can't remember exactly when, was that we need to have an initiative within our city, that it is an initiative to buy local, because the surrounding cities have a buy local several times of the year, and we don't have that. So I introduced that to them and asked them to please look into it, look into other cities that have such a program and what the cost would be to start that program. So my question here is, I know that there is great initiatives out there. We need to discover or do our due diligence to find what the cost would be. My question, how many of you are members of the chamber? Okay. What I had asked them to do and what they need to understand is not everybody can afford the chamber dues. And I understand that being a small business, because you get to a point sometimes with your profits, do you write this paycheck? Or do you pay the chamber dues? Do you pay the light bill? Or do you pay the chamber dues? I understand that completely. Have a membership based upon a year where you are a member, so that you can see what the what you will gain from being a member of the chamber. What are the advantages? And have a free 1-year membership, and then after that, should you decide to join, you can do so. But I think that is an initiative in which this group, you've started something here. So take what you have got here, all of your comments, take this to the chamber, give this to the director, and give this to the board president. Duke Fakuri is the board president and Williams is the director. Give this to them and let them hear what you have got to say. The training aspect of it, absolutely, Shannon, it is a real problem, not only with Pine Bluff, but nationwide. I was at an event last night when we were talking about the employment pipeline and how that has been changing and how there is a significant gap in the employment pipeline nationwide. And how do you fill that gap? We need skilled workers, and not every young person, education, Scott, I agree with you so much. Education is the key to a healthy community. You can have communities that the crime levels are sustainable, livable, and we're getting there. Every year we're getting there. Every month we're getting there. The other factor is education. So we have got to really focus on the educational part. And not being able to reveal everything because of confidentiality with a particular company, and I don't do that. But one of the things that I've been saying is that we need to offer programs, apprenticeships, associate's degrees or certificates where we can train and people are learning a particular skill in whatever area it may be in. It doesn't make any difference, but you have got this certificate or certification to go anywhere you need to go in the service industry. When you look at HVAC, when you look at master electricians and plumbers, they make a very healthy living. So I'm not saying do not do the four-year institution. I'm saying find out what you love, where's your passion, and then grow that. So I challenge this group to take your message to the chamber. Build upon what you're doing today, come up with a structured plan, and take it to the chamber as to what you need, because that's what they're there for. They're there to service small business in any way. And I do know that they have got some training going on, different types of training. It may be that they need to expand upon that, or they need to stop this training and add this training. I can't speak to that. But what I'm saying is take your message to the chamber, because I believe that they will have the financial means to be able to develop a program that you would like, if that's where you want to go with it. But buy a local program, absolutely. And it is out there. You can create it however you want to. There are generic programs. We can tweak it to make it work for Pine Bluff.
I'm Bill Bromit. I'm on the Pine Bluff City Council, and I own a partner with another fellow named Andy Taylor with Bromit Taylor and Associates. We do insurance, financial services. We do income taxes. We do about anything we can do to help people with financial needs. And we're right down here on Dalloway Road, 4822 Dalloway Road. You know, a lot of people say they drive right by and don't see us. We've got to find a way to get some big lights or something on our place, I guess. But I remember the first meeting we had, and we only had like four people. Mm-hmm. This is good to see a good group of folks here today. This is great. I'm sorry I'm late.
Okay. I think the next part of the meeting, we need to just have interaction. And what I'm hearing so far is that we need two different type of things on our to-do list. One is some type of class that's on customer service, and another is some kind of shop local campaign. And maybe if we can get some committees to do these two things, then we could take those to the chamber, see if the chamber is willing to help us, or because I know a lot of people can't afford the dues, and I understand that. So if they can or can't, and then maybe we need to regroup from that point. I'd also like to see us meet every Monday morning. I think Monday mornings are a good day. That's the beginning of the week. We can start off in prayer for our businesses, for our city, and just kind of rejuvenate us for that whole week. I'd like to know, you know, what does everyone think about times to meet? What committee you'd like to maybe be on? Do you see another, you know, something else that we need to work on, but you know, besides these two items?
It's not just all about the money. You know, we were, well, he may not even know it, but we were a member of the chamber. I don't feel like you get anything out of it. The website was never updated. Our company name was never on the website. You know, the red coats, they go around, they do business openings for companies, and we were 2 years, and I asked a red coat, I'm like, you know, how come they go to this one, but they don't go to ours or to, you know, the other one? And they said, well, you have to ask them to come. Well, I think that's ridiculous. you know, if somebody opens a business in Pine Bluff, I think the red coat should be there if, you know, if they join the chamber. And so, I mean, I just have, it's just not all about the money. You know, I just think that there are some things that.
Really quickly, I just want to just piggyback on a couple of topics we talked about as far as supporting business and shopping local. There's a national campaign out now through American Express. It's called Shop Small Saturdays. And maybe that we can try to integrate something along that line, because whoever accepts credit cards as far as through American Express, they will build you into their website, so whoever has a credit card knows to come to shop at your store. So maybe there's some way that we can incorporate something of our own. We can come up with our own slogan, whatever it is.
Right.
I have an idea, but you know, you don't have to go with my name, but I'll tell you my idea.
Okay.
It's just called Big on Pine Bluff.
Okay.
So I just thought that was a good idea, and maybe we can just, you know, elaborate on that, but that's how we can get people to start, you know, shopping more local instead of going, you know, out of town or Memphis or something like that.
We need an acronym, Big on Pine Bluff. I like Big on.
Kind of building on that a little bit, I think isn't the one in Little Rock Big on Little Rock? Isn't that
something like that?
Yeah, and so maybe I love the idea, but maybe changing the wording just a little bit to where it's unique to us. Mayor Hollingsworth's right. You know, one of the great things about being in a small business group is that somebody else has a successful campaign that's similar, and we don't have to reinvent the wheel. That's the great thing about being small business and not being big business. So we look around at what does work, much like what the city has done with the police department and finding, you know, programs that have worked in other places to bring crime down. And much like, you know, and that's so looking around and they're right, just to find something that's working somewhere else, get it working here, show that we have the capability, we have the resources to help people, to give them what they need, to give them that we can find the right help.
Mm-hmm.
You know, one of my frustrations around here that I've told several people is that the only fully funded youth program we have in Jefferson County is the prison. I want you to think about that for a minute. And one of the struggles that I see in Pine Bluff a lot is that you get different groups that all form and they all get excited, but they don't work together.
Mm-hmm.
And so we have, you know, we've got to do a better job of networking with the other people who are here, who are trying, and try to find a way to work together with them to fund. Because you're right. Nobody has the, you know, a lot of people don't have the money for chamber memberships or other things. But there are ways to get together, to work together in cost-effective ways, and show that we can work across whatever lines there are towards the common goal of making this a better place to live and to making our businesses survive here, not only survive but flourish.
The event that I attended, and it was regarding economic development, and one of the stats that the numbers were updated that were rather staggering to me is that for a person to be incarcerated is $23,000 a year. To send a child to school is $6,600 a year. That is just mind-boggling to me. And so why not invest in those children early on? And that's part of the problem that I keep saying, and my husband and I were talking about this morning, we're missing the boat with education and grooming our kids from K-5 all the way up. We are missing the boat, not just Pine Bluff, nationwide. I'm not gonna get on my soapbox on that one.
I wanna add about the education and that chamber, let's say, does not offer much. Besides that, I think it would be great if I can record each of our meeting to prove Pine Bluff that we're actually doing something. I'll volunteer to do that. But then, you know, we could have classes or webinars that you can buy them nationwide for ridiculous prices, okay? Or it could be part of your membership and you get good customer service classes or whatever we come up with, and it will be part of your membership, and it's just a video that they get access to once they sign up, and that I think that will be beneficial because they will be able to learn from great Pine Bluff business owners and who they can relate to. And it's just a little perk that they could get for, you know, sign up for Chamber of Commerce.
This makes me nervous, but I'm kind of shy. So I've been waiting on an opportunity to talk to a group of people like y'all for a long, long time. I've got a lot of ideas, and my business is flourished. I mean, I do really, really good. It's small. It's unique. I provide a service. I'm a welder. I've taught several peoples in our community how to weld. I've sent them on down the road. You know, I hire them, I teach them something, and then they take it, you know. And that's where we're losing. They're leaving and going other places. And I think it's just the bad overcast that Pine Bluff has left. Everybody ran. Instead of standing up and fighting for what you believe and what you love, everybody ran. They, you know, they got out of here. Everybody's going to Whitehall. You know, the tax rates are slightly lower at Whitehall, so I could understand new business opening up, maybe going that way, you know, so I can understand that part of it. But there's just so many things that we could do to involve the community. The community don't know about these people sitting right here that cares about them, that's doing their passion and going to work every day to provide a service for this community. And they really don't understand that, and there's nothing putting us out there like that, you know. And you know, just small things on the education thing. I would challenge anyone in this room to show up at Townsend Park Elementary at lunchtime and see how our children's treated. Mm-hmm. That is a challenge to everybody in this room. They treat them like inmates. They won't let them talk. They're looking at the person in front of them in line's feet. If they look up and look away, they're hollered at. I mean, it's really a disgrace. And you go to other schools and do the same thing at the same time, and they're treated like children, like they're loved. And it's more like, I worked at the prison system, so I know how you walk down the road and don't look at nothing. You know what I mean? So in my eyes, that's what it portrayed to me, is more like my kids is walking through a hallway going to the cell block, mm-hmm. rather than their classroom. Mm-hmm. You know, it's honestly unreal, the difference. And see, I grew up, I'm not pulling no race, but I grew up the minority. I went to Dollarway my whole life. I don't see color. Money's green, you know, and but, you know, I really put my hat down to everyone in this room for trying, because that's what we're lacking, is people who care and try, and everybody ran. You know what I mean? And I believe this will be a good thing.
To kind of piggyback on what Tony was saying, with my job, I travel a lot. I travel within the borders of Arkansas, also travel outside of Arkansas. And I think it was Trisha, I mentioned this too the other day, Pine Bluff, we all know the rap that Pine Bluff gets. And people are real quick on the internet and everything, Facebook, the, you know, crime bluff jokes and stuff like that. I started seeing some of that the first year, and I was sitting here, wait a minute. I was like, I realize we've had one murder. But when you look, and I'm not knocking Little Rock, but therefore a week and a half, 2 week time period, Little Rock had a shooting every day to start the new year off. You had the brawls at the mall that they had to call in 200 cops to break up on New Year's Day. You're not seeing that here. And Park Plaza, they had to call in 200 police officers to break up a brawl. A bunch of teenagers just throwing down. But there's something that I've noticed, and I'm sure you've noticed it all too, maybe you haven't thought about it, but look at, you know, we talk about revitalizing Pine Bluff, look at Little Rock, look at the River Market. You know, 20, 25 years ago, the River Market was an area that people considered riddled with crime, businesses were gone. Look at it today. Same thing, I cover Arkansas State, the college that I cover. I've been to Mobile, Alabama three of the past 4 years, and where they're at down in their downtown area reminded me a lot of Main Street and Pine Bluff. And same thing, their business owners got together, they started putting money into the community. Now they got a 4-block by 16-block area that there may be 2 or 3 buildings that are empty. The rest of them are open. You know, there's sports bars, there's restaurants, there's things to do. And we got a lot of that here. You know, we got plenty of motels, we got a lot of good restaurants, things like that. But I've always kind of thought to myself, you know, look at areas like that, what worked for them, apply that. And I know the mayor's done a great job of doing a lot of that already. And we mentioned the police department and the job that they've done. And I've been very impressed with the drop in crime. You know, something Tony talked about with Townsend Park also, there was something that bothered me. My kids went there for a short time. And my son, granted he, and Trisha knows him, granted he's very smart, he kept getting the lead roles at 6 years old in all the plays. And we asked him, I said, was he just that good? And the teacher says, no, he's just one of six kids out of 90 that can read. And that doesn't just fall on the teachers, that falls on responsibility at home with parents, mm-hmm. taking the time out to read to their children. You know, my wife and I do that. I got a three-year-old now. We're reading to her. We got her little Moby Go thing that has got games on it. She's got to spell out words. We got her on, you know, all these internet things, ABC Mouse, PBS Kids, things like that. But education is big, as we've all mentioned. And there's two things that I thought about with my business personally, and one of them I mentioned to the mayor already. Those of you that grew up in Pine Bluff, you'll probably remember the King Cotton Classic. Yeah. You know, we have got the Pine Bluff Convention Center still good enough. It's still nice enough. And I've mentioned to the mayor, I would like to bring a holiday tournament back like that. And I can't do it by myself. I'm not trying to pitch anybody, but I can't do it by myself. But at the same time, we do have a journalism department at UAPB. Some of those people need some real world experience. I would be willing to bring on some interns to go around with me. You know, we do print media, we do video. There's three different aspects that we do. And, you know, maybe that's something that we can all do fine. You know, we have the Votech school also. You know, there's things out there that people can do that they need some internships. Get out there, see what it's like in the real world. And you mentioned passion. I spent 8 years in the Army, was diagnosed with diabetes. That ended my military career literally overnight. I've never seen them put someone out so quick. I was diagnosed 48 hours later. I was discharged. And I came home to one last paycheck from the Army, no job, struggled to get my diabetes under control. Then I started this business I got now from scratch on pennies on the dollar out of my bedroom, well, with a laptop, and 10 years later, I'm still here and thriving.
Kind of some pointers off of what you said. Well, if y'all said, I understand what you said about running, because when I first opened, the scariest thing for me was, are you gonna get any support? And from here, I would go visit my wife's family, which is in Texas, and I would go by many places, and her family was like, well, you should have did it here, you get more. And then you come back, and it started off relatively slow. And at the beginning, you do want to run, because then you're wondering, like, did I do this in the growing city? People say that the city is bad, and I don't know if people are going to support, because this seems like it's not enough income, or it's not enough people. Will people support you? And that is scary, and it will make you want to run. But at the same time, I thought to myself, I grew up here. What they're saying, I know everything is not true, because I lived here and I'm still alive, and I had the opportunity to open a business, so it can't be that bad. So I stuck to it. And I believe that not people can see that you have a business, they can see that, but the passion sets everything else aside. They see that you're still there, you still open every day, you still push it, you still do day to day. And I think that says a lot. And if we can show that, it's getting, I always ponder in my mind, like, how do I let people see this? They can see me here, but how can they see what's actually going on? Passing by is not enough. You need to see what's happening here. And that's probably one thing we could do. And the video thing is a major benefit. I do YouTube a lot. I don't know if you all noticed, a lot of companies do that, and videos help a lot, whether it's commercial, whether it's newspaper. At one point, somebody told me that doesn't help. This organization being put in Pine Bluff commercial, being put on a commercial, being put where people can see it, will actually let people see what's happening, and maybe they will be more involved. They don't know. I mean, I feel there's a great deal of people that feel some type of way knowing that entrepreneurs come together to find out how we can make it better for the community. I believe people will really, you know, they really feel good about that, and that will help as well. So
what you just said about the commercial, about advertising and people knowing that you're here, that is an extremely good way to advertise for people to know, because a lot of people take the paper. I've had a lot of customers come in and say, oh, we seen you in a paper, so we just wanted to stop by and check you out. They bought something, so that's bringing dollars to the city. My problem with the commercial is it is extremely expensive. I don't have a problem with the commercial. Right. They report, but it is extremely expensive. And most people can't afford to get the ads in there. I mean, just a business card is like $90.
Right.
I mean, it's we were luckily blessed enough to get on the front page because they heard about us, so they came down and did a special report. But besides that, you're not going to get on the front page unless it's something negative half the time. I mean, it's just the truth. It's really expensive.
Sometimes I was on there, they did it by choice. They came
yep. Right,
city,
right,
so
yep.
Again, I want to go back and talk about the chamber because as a, I think, 35-year member of the chamber until a couple of years ago when I left my place of employment, we have a very strong chamber in Pine Bluff. Known regionally, statewide, for being a strong chamber because it operates in a very difficult business environment. I'm shocked to hear that it missed an opportunity to red coat at a business that opened that didn't make. That's unusual, and I'm sure there's a reason for that. But we have a strong chamber and a long history of supporting small businesses, including programs by local, yes, customer service training, yes, they have that, and training for professionals, perhaps a better job of communicating with our business public should be done. But we have a very strong chamber and known statewide in terms of number of businesses that support our chamber here. Further, I want to comment on a statement that I made a few minutes ago. When we pursue things like buy local, yes, the chamber has a program. I've heard comments that when we talk about buying local, careful that we make use of the professional services that we have through our chamber. Remember, we are a regional hub. Southeast Arkansas. Folks, I contend we would not have a mall if we didn't have regional purchases. You see, folks, you can't buy your partner a Easter suit between Pine Bluff and Greenville, Mississippi from a chain store unless it's in Pine Bluff. We do extremely well regionally in Pine Bluff. So in crafting our buy local program, think about it. Pine Bluff, a population of near 50,000 people, I'm sitting in a business that I can own, the only business I believe I can get a late night bacon, eggs, and hash brown. We well know that we've lost businesses that do overnight business because of, well, violence and crime. So let's make sure that we support the businesses that are surviving in Pine Bluff and every opportunity that we have. Let's speak positively of businesses that defy what we hear about Little Rock overnight meal places. And challenge our chamber to make startups of small businesses, because it is small businesses that grow and survive, as I mentioned, in this community and defy what we hear regionally. Thank you.
Last year, the mayor and I worked to get money allocated to do a marketing campaign or to work on developing a marketing campaign for Pine Bluff. We got a lot of resistance on the council that just didn't see the benefit of it. We finally did get it approved. We did have a group, Oakley, and that wasn't that their names,
yes.
Debbie?
Oakley Research.
Yeah. They did focus groups in Pine Bluff and Little Rock, and they brought in people, about a dozen people, and I've seen the video of exactly, they were just sitting around a table like this and had them talk about Pine Bluff. I tell you, it was pretty amazing, actually, how it went down, particularly the people in Little Rock. It was almost like I really came out of that feeling like, after watching that those people up there really want to help us. They feel sorry for us. They want to try to find a way to help Pine Bluff be what it can be. I'm very serious. I wish you could all see it, because it was just very interesting. And how many of them out of the dozen or so people that had close ties to Pine Bluff? that were in the group. Some of them had went to school here and left and this and that. And then, of course, they talked about, you know, crime. It was the biggest, one of the biggest things they talked about. And, you know, I agree with whoever said it a while ago, we've got to put the word out that statistically crime is down 31%. You know, there's a lot of people that, you know, I heard one alderman the other day saying that she did not believe the numbers. Well, the numbers are what they are, you know, and crime is down. We may still have some issues, but it is definitely down, and things are much, much better, and I commend Mayor Hollingsworth for all her efforts to help make that happen. We also had several things that we did in that focus group to, one thing was, and I don't know if you noticed tonight, but the Pine Bluff Commercial has a calendar of events on the whole page that has what's going on around town. That kind of came out of that. We also did some other things like we were going to develop a website. It hadn't, the funding was taken away by the council, so we can't complete what we started to do. But we had a, we were going to do a website for kids where they could go on their smartphones, iPads, whatever. Joe Dempsey worked on it and pretty much got it put together, but it would take about probably $7,000 or $8,000 to finish it and get it online and make it where the kids could go on their cell phone. And what do we call it? Youth
activity
bulletin board. That's what it was going to be. And Joe pretty well has it put together. We just need to find some money to be able to implement it. And the idea was it would be where anybody, a church group or anybody, could go online, put it on there, particularly things for kids, because that's what all these kids, as you all know, that's what they're doing. That's where they're getting their information. And it was a very innovative idea, but we don't have the funding now to do it. You know, I was chairman of the Advertising and Tourist Promotion Commission for several years, and recently was, I'm not on it anymore. But we did a lot of really good things, and I just got a text from Bob Purvis, and he said it was kind of ironic, but he just met with the commercial and the radio stations about a Buy Pine Bluff campaign. And what they're, and a lot of, you know, we never got any of this really going. I'm still working with them every day, you know, trying to help them get things done. But the idea was for the A&P Commission to provide funding to help, in other words, be like a co-op advertising campaign. And you know, you're saying how much it cost. Well, if you could get it for half, you might do it, you know. And that's what Bob's talking about, is trying to develop a campaign where that we could help co-op. You know, we talked about having like a full page ad and this convention center buy it, and then you buy out pieces at a reduced rate. But at the bottom, they'd have Positively Pine Bluff or something that would promote the city that would justify, you know, the A&P Commission using the funding. So that opportunity is there, and I'll get that information to everybody once Bob gets it firmed up. One thing I'd suggest is that we find a way to where we can all communicate with each other. You know, if you got a list going around or anything to get email addresses and.
What about like a closed?
You've already got the Facebook group, the closed Facebook group. Why not just use that? What we already have.
We are presently interviewing people for a marketing director's job. We have interviewed one person from Greenville, Mississippi, which was has Pine Bluff roots, an extensive background in marketing. One of the things that came from that research group is that, and what I learned last year going to Washington, is that cities that are progressive and moving forward, they have a marketing director that markets their city. They promote their city, just like you promote a business. And I firmly believe that getting this person on board, and this person's sole purpose is to counteract any negative thing that comes out. So if something negative does come out, you offset it with a positive. We've never done that in our city, and we're going to take a very aggressive approach with this. One of the things we also learned, too, is how do you communicate the information out to the citizens? We have learned that there is some type of a roadblock there. How do you get beyond that? That's what this research group helped us with. And there's several different avenues in getting information out to the people. But just this one interview from this very energetic person opened our eyes to the possibilities of how you turn our city around within several months. It was so motivating and inspirational, and the hope and the how you could just perceive and see our city was wonderful. So that's getting ready to happen as soon as we get through with all of the interviews. We've got several lined up. And but two or three are from Pine Bluff, but the majority are from outside our state wanting to come back to our city and help turn it around. So.